So you can see here, this hydrant, the engineer basically didn't spell out on the as-built drawings of what he needed. The hydrant is about 3 feet too high for this particular application. It should be 24 inches minimum. It could be up to 3 feet. I can't really tell without my rule here. But you can see the grade. It's there's almost 4 feet of the barrel exposed. It's just a straight piece of ductile iron. That's actually the barrel. It's a 1991 K-81A. It's rated for 150 PSI. The grease fitting, as you can see, is here on operating nut, and it looks like there's no evidence of grease. It's never been greased. There's no grease on the nozzles, as you can see. I can tell that it's never been greased properly. It's probably poorly maintained. The isolation valve looks like the top's been hit by a snow plow here on the valve box, but any evidence of the direction of the valve box, if I come back in 5 years and see it at this direction, it's obvious that they're not exercising a valve when they flush the hydrant, which they should be. But it's another example of poor engineering, and the in-house engineer, the county engineer, didn't catch it, and certainly the engineer who designed this project didn't catch this, and the inspector didn't catch this. So it's a lot of people at fault here, but there's just no sense in this. This would be a very hard hydrant to operate in for the firemen to operate. I mean, look where the operating height should be at your waist, and you can see there's my waist, so it's almost 19 inches too high to where the hydrant height should be. This would be extremely difficult. This is almost up to my chin. You're putting the operating nut just to get enough torque and not hurt yourself. So it's another liability for the firemen and whoever's maintaining this. They have to operate it and flush it periodically, or it's going to be galled up, which it looks like it. Doesn't look like much has ever been done with it, so it's a shame. But anyway, Scott Shipe with Water Advocacy. Have a great day, and please subscribe to my site. Thank you.